Hello everybody, I hope you guys are all having a great day. If you guys are new to my channel, I'm Lori and welcome to Lori's Book Trials, and I'll be back. Hi everybody. So I thought what would be fun is, since I don't know what I want to read, I'm going to pick out of my TBR thing. I did a video and I'll link it later on down in the description in case you didn't see it, but it just came up today where I put certain challenges in here, and like one might say, read a book that has pink on the cover. This one doesn't, but I'm just giving that example. Or read a mystery book, or read a male author, or, you know. And I thought it would be fun, since I don't know what I want to read next, I will pick from here. But what I'm gonna do is I'm going to roll the dice, and whatever number comes up first, that's how many prompts I gotta pick out. So if six comes out, then I have to pick out six of these. If two comes out, I have to pick out two of them, and then I'm gonna roll it again, and the second time, if it's a one, then I have 1 month to finish these books. But the only thing is that if it's, like, if I have six books and I only have a month to do it, then I'm gonna re-roll it. So I gotta at least have 2 months to read six books, just because I have, unless I can fit all six into, like, next month's contemporary-thon or something like that. Even though one of the books I'm gonna start reading now, so. But yeah, I think that's what I'm going to do. So, I'm going to stop the camera, and I'm going to turn it for it will face the other way. And then we will see how many I have to pick out, and how long I have to read them. And then I will turn the camera back after that and pick out the props. And then I will look to see what books I can fit. I'm not going to pick out all of the books right away, since unless it's only like, well, yeah, so what I'll do is I'll pick out like two or three of the books. Like if there's six, then I'll pick out three of the books, and then I'll, you know, find something for those, so something like that. Because I got 2 weeks, well, a little less than 2 weeks or something like that until the end of the month, so I might be able to read a couple of them this month. So I'll probably pick out 2 to 3 and show you what I picked and what the prompt was, of course, again. So what prompt it fit. So, yeah, I'll be back. All right, I'm back. Okay, I'm going to roll the dice once. We got 4. So I got to pick 4 prompts out of my TBR thing. And then we have 4 months to read them. Cool. I wonder what I would do if I got another one. Yeah, good thing I did that one didn't come up. But we had a 4. You guys saw that. So I have 4 books I have to pick, 4 prompts I got to pick out of this. And I have 4 months to read the 4 books. Of course, I can get it done quicker than that. I'll be back with... And I'll pick out 4 of those things to see what it is, and then I will pick out, and then I'll stop it again and pick out some books that will fit that category, and then we'll get started. Okay, I'll be back. Okay, I am back. Okay, we'll pick out 4. Ready? Okay. 1. Go with. Oops, I got 2. This one. Well, let's redo it again. Okay, let's try again. Okay, this one. 2 more. And also, I have the right to, like, turn. Like, if I'm not ready for one of them, then I have a right to pick a different one. Especially if it's, like, in a series, because, yeah. Actually, no, because I could probably finish a book and then do the next one in the series. So we'll just go ahead and keep it this way. Okay, 3. Let's get this one 4. Alright. Sorry, my nose is itchy. Okay, let's open up the first one. But say, I'll tell you one thing though. If something happens and I can't get into a certain book, then I have the right to, you know, pick out a different book. But I only can do that like only 2 times, so I have to do that wisely. Only 2 times for the whole year I'm talking about, not just for like, you know, that month or those 4 months, whatever the dice lands on. So but this is the first one. It says read a book of the month. Book. I usually read a book of the month each month anyways. I read 1, 2 so far this month. So the other one is read a romance book. Okay. Next month is romance. Actually, I had that one book that is for romance Monopoly, and I still haven't read it yet, so I could always pick that one for that one. But I got other romance books that I want to read too, so. Then we got, oops, sorry. Read a sci-fi or fantasy, which I do every month, so. And the last one. And the last one is read a middle grade book. I think I can handle those. Okay, I'm going to look around and see which ones interest me and go from there. I will be back once I figure out the books. Okay, I'm back. Okay, for the first one, which is that I put them in a certain way. Okay, for read a romance book, I picked out The Princess Plan by Julie London. A Royal Wedding. I'm not exactly sure. This is Print and Pop and Glory. Pomp, how we say it, and Glory. Not crushes on commoners. Nothing gets the tongue of London high society wagon like a good scandal. And when the personal security of the visiting Prince Sebastian of Alexia, something like that, is found murdered, it's all anyone could talk about, including Eliza Treacle, thank how you say it. Her unapologetic gossip gaze has benefited from an anonymous tip about a crime, prompting Sebastian to take an interest in playing detective, and an even greater interest in Liza. Says with a trade deal on the line and mountain pressure to secure a noble bride, there's nothing more than a prince dallying with a commoner. Sebastian finds Eliza's country manner as frustrating as it is seductive, but they'll have to work together if they're going to catch the culprit. And when things heat up behind closed doors, it's the prince who'll have to decide what comes first, his country or his heart. So, that's one of the books I got to read in the next 4 months. For read a middle grade, which is the one that one of the books that Vince picked out for me that I have to read by the end of the year. This one, of course, I read before, but it was a long time ago. And then I started rereading it, and I put it down, and then Vince picked it for me. So it's a perfect excuse to start it, right? But this one I won't read right away because this one is going to have a separate a separate thing. It's going to be like a book diary thing. Since it's been so long since I read it, I don't even remember how I felt about it. I'm sure I liked it because I wound up buying all the other books. But I just read the first couple, so yeah. So I'm really excited about this one. So, of course, this is where they wind up going to like fairyland or whatever you want to call it, like the different stories, storybooks, whatever you want to say. So, there's that one. For read a sci-fi or fantasy, I'm going to read The Eighth Guardian because I want to read the series and see how it ends. I read this, but it was when it first came out, and this is like time travel. She gets like, she ain't supposed to graduate. She's just doing the testing, but they pick her, and she finds out that she has to like, that what they do is they go back and try to fix the past, but they can't be seen. So it's really good. They're not supposed to be seen, and it's basically what happens if you, you know, if you mess up, you know, everything. And the last one, book of the month. Man, I didn't realize I bent that a little bit. I picked The Turn of the Key by Ruth Ware. This one I picked because I know, I tried reading it before, and I was supposed to buddy read it. That's why it's like this. But I just wasn't in the mood for it, so I put it down. So I want to try and actually read this book and see if I'm gonna love it like so many people do, or if I'm gonna hate it or just be indifferent. So this is about this lady. She answers an ad to be a nanny, I guess. I don't know. And there's like a smart house, and one of the her charges, one of the kids, is murdered, and she is in jail because they think she's the one that murdered the child. And this is her writing notes to a lawyer, trying to get him to help her because she knows she didn't do it. So yeah, sounds like it's gonna be good. It's just that I just wasn't in the mood for it at the time. So yeah. So we'll see if I can actually finish it this time. If I, what is it called? If I don't finish this book and I change my mind about it and I can't get into it, then it's, I'm not going to get rid of it, but it's going to be the first time DNF in it, because the first time I didn't DNF it, I just put it down. But it'll be my first time because I got that rule where I do 1, 2, 3 strikes, you're out. So if I'm not in the mood for it, I will, like I said, put it down, and it'll be the first time I kind of DNF it. And I will pick out a different prompt. Or a different book, I mean. Not a different prompt, a different book. But it has to be still a book of the month. But yeah, so I'm going to try this. And I'll decide in a little bit when I'm going to start reading, and you'll know when I start updating you guys. But I'm going to let you guys go, and I'll talk to you guys all later. Hi everybody, so I started the book that I decided to start with first, and that is The Turn of the Key by Ruth Ware. I'm already like writing stuff down in the book, like just certain things, which in a minute I'll talk about, so it's going to be spoilery. Well, it's going to be spoilery. One thing is spoilery because it's actually a thing. The other one is just like a theory I have. Or I'm just wondering. But anyways, I'll talk about that in a minute. So once I'm ready to talk about this, what I think might be spoilery, then I will let you guys know by saying it's spoilery, and then you guys can skip ahead until the book goes down. But so far, I'm really enjoying it. Very interesting. Like I said, I'm already writing stuff down. And I am on page 7. I just finished page 74, which ended very strangely. So I cannot wait to find out more about this book. So far, I will say, like, because I tried reading, what's the other one? Lock Every Door by Riley Sager? How do you say the name? And I put that one down because I wasn't feeling it either at the time. But I gotta say, so far, this one I'm liking better than what I remember from reading the other book. So, Lock Every Door. But I will try later on to read Lock Every Door again. Even though I got kind of spoiled for what happened, but I'll still read it because I don't know what led up to it and all that. I don't know, like, all the stuff that went down that led to this, what happened. So, yeah. But this one is really good. So, now I'm going to do spoiler or what I think is spoilers and theories and stuff like that. So, please don't watch until this goes down and then you can watch again. Okay. So, one thing that I'm wondering, because of something she says, let me find it. I mean, the way she acts. I'll tell you what I wrote down. I'll tell you what I wrote down. Let me hold on a minute. Let me find the one I'm talking about. Because I tabbed it. So, because I wrote it and I tabbed it. My eye is itching, it's driving me cuckoo. So, anyways, I wrote down. So she says, so she meets this guy, his name's Jack. He's the one that's taken her to where she's supposed to be nannying if she gets a job. Well, of course we know she gets a job. But anyways, and he says, after you, Rowan, and then she says, for a moment I didn't move, almost forgetting who he was speaking to. Then with a start, I pulled myself together and climbed into the car. So, is she not who she's supposed to be? Because that is weird that he says her name and then she says she almost forgot who he was talking about. Like, if she was Rowan, she would know her own name, right? It just seems weird to me. So, but I put down interesting. Act like I should put acting like she didn't know who Jack was talking about when he said the name Rowan. Some type of clue, maybe? Because that's what I think. And then there's a part where, after she's getting ready to leave. Hello. She's getting ready to leave the dog, and one of the girls grabbed her by the leg and stuff. And then she's like, she says to her, "Don't come here." Sorry, the dog. But she says, "Maddie," that's one of the girls. She says, "Don't come here," she whispered, still refusing to look up. "It's not safe." And then Rowan says, "It's not safe." I gave a little laugh. "Maddie, what do you mean?" And she says, "Not safe," she repeated with a little angry sob, shaking her head harder so that her words were almost lost. "They wouldn't like it. Who wouldn't like it?" But with that, she tore herself away, and then she was running barefoot across the grass, shouting something over her shoulder. And then when she's getting, Rowan's getting ready to leave, let me find it. It was only as we began to wind slowly down the drive while I kept my eye out for a fleeing child among the trees that I found myself replaying Maddie's final remark, wondering if she had really said what I thought I heard. For the thing she had called over her shoulder seemed almost too preposterous. Preposterous? How do you say that word? To be true. And yet, the more I brooded over it, the more I was sure of what I heard. The ghost, she sobbed. The ghost wouldn't like it. So, and we find out that all these nannies are leaving and stuff like that. So I'm wondering if the nannies are the ghost. Maybe they were killed and not just left. But if that's the case, I don't know who would have killed them. You know? So I'm just really confused. But I got some theories. I like to try to like write down stuff if I think about it and see if I'm right or not. But yeah, so I'm very curious to find out what's all going on. But I will talk to you guys all later. I don't want this to be too long of a video, even though it's probably going to be like 40, 50 minutes like all my other ones have been being, or at least close to 40 minutes. But yeah, really good book so far. Oh, I wanted to show you guys. I did get a book yesterday. I didn't even realize that Amazon would ship on, I mean, give you something on a holiday, but I got They Both Die at the End by Adam Savera. This is that one where they get like a call like a little bit before, 24 hours before they're supposed to die, to let them know that this is going to be their last day, basically. And I forget the people's name, Matato and Ruffus, they both get a call. And there's an app where you can meet the other person that's going to die on the same day, and you can meet up. So that's what this is about. So it looks really good. I cannot wait to read it. I'm probably going to read this. This spoiler alert, this will probably be one of my book picks for Contemporary-a-thon. I believe this is contemporary, that this has contemporary in it. I'm going to double check. But if it is contemporary, you know, if it has some contemporary in it, or if it says contemporary at all on Goodreads, then I'm going to go ahead and read this. Because there is a prompt LGBT, I think, for the Contemporary-a-thon. So if that is, or diverse. Diverse set of characters, one or the other. So, yeah. Whichever the prompt is, that's probably what this one's going to be. But yeah, I'm going to let you guys go. I'll talk to you guys all later. Hello, everybody. Today's Thursday, so sorry I didn't update you guys at all yesterday. I just was not feeling good. I didn't read at all because I had a real bad stomach ache and a real bad headache and my body was hurting. So I did not read anything yesterday, so that's why I didn't update you. I am getting closer to being done with The Turn of the Key. I am now currently on page 261. I'm getting ready to read page 261. And I don't remember 300 and something pages I think there is. I'll tell you guys in a minute. There's 336 pages. So I'm getting close. Hopefully I will finish this tonight. Because this vlog is only supposed to be until tonight. And then it's supposed to go up. Because it's Tuesday through Thursday's vlog. And yeah. And it's almost, and it's like after 5 in the evening. So we shall see if this works and I get it done tomorrow. Hopefully I will. But yeah, really creepy. Like, I kind of know a little bit about what's going on. At least I think I know what her secret is. I know she has a secret, this girl. I always forget her name. Rowan? Why am I forgetting that name when my dog's name is Rowan? But anyways, Rowan, yeah. I think she has some kind of secret, and I think I know what the secret is. Just by the way she acts at certain times. So, yeah, I'm curious to see if I'm right about that. But for who's doing whatever is going, I mean, who killed the kid or the baby, whoever dies, yeah, I don't know that. I have some suspicions, but I kind of think it might be the other person that I'm thinking of. And I don't want to mention it because I don't want to spoil it if I'm right. But yes, very, 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 very good. I don't think it's going to be like a 6-star, like a favorite of the year. And I don't feel it being a 5. But it feels like it's going to be at least a 4. 4.25, maybe a 4.75, depending on the ending. But it just doesn't quite feel like a 5-star read. And it definitely don't feel like a favorite of the year. It doesn't give me the same feelings as Infinity Sun and the Sundown Motel did, which both got 6 stars from me. So yeah, but it definitely is a good book. So either, you know, a 4.25 to a 4.75 is still a really good for a mystery book. Sorry about the noise. My son has Rowan, the dog, not the character, going cuckoo. So yes, but I'm going to let you guys go. But yeah, I'm really enjoying it. And that's all I'm going to say for right now. I'll talk to you guys all when I finish it. Hopefully tonight. Hi, everybody. I finally finished it. Yay! I gave it a 4.5. Of course, on Goodreads, I only gave it a 4-star. But I did give it a 4.5, you know, for me. The only thing that made me knock it down, because I was thinking about giving it either a 5 or a 4.75. But you guys know me about endings. There's a certain way I don't like it. And I kind of guessed a couple of things. Like, I guessed 2 things. I didn't know why I was feeling this exactly. Besides for one of the things. I knew why I was feeling it for one of the things. I just didn't know why. And then the other thing. So there was two things that I figured out, at least pertaining these people. But why, I didn't know. So that's, yeah. And I didn't really like the ending. But if the ending would have been a little bit more my style of an ending. And, hi, Robin.
Hello.
My girl. And
good night.
She said night, everybody. But yeah, but if the ending would have been a little bit more my style, like I was saying, and if I wouldn't have guessed anything, I would have liked it more. But it was still a really good read, because 4.5 is not a bad rating, especially for a mystery. Because I look at certain things more, I'm more critical for mysteries. Like, you guys know, I haven't hardly gave any mysteries anything over a 4.5. Or a 4, I mean. Usually my mysteries are about 4. But every once in a while I find one that's like a 4.5 or a 5 or a favorite of the year. Like the Sundown Motel. But usually the highest I give it is a 4. So a 4.5 is really, really good. Really good. So it was a good book. I definitely am glad I finally actually finished it. Because like I said, I picked it up last year and was going to read it and I just wasn't feeling it. So I'm really glad that I wound up liking it a little bit more. Yay! I need to read The Turn of the Key by Riley Sager. Sager, how do you say it? So I might read that soon. And I'm definitely going to be reading The Broken Girls by Simone St. James soon. So, yeah. But I'm really, really glad that I wound up loving this book. Because I was worried since I wasn't feeling it the first time around. But, yay. But, yes. This will be the end of this reading vlog. I don't know when I'm going to do a reading vlog, like I was saying. I don't think I'll do one tomorrow. If I do, it'll probably be just when the kids are, like, when my kids get home in the afternoon, or the late afternoon when they get home, where they can watch the kids for a little bit, why I film a little bit. But other than that, I don't think I'm going to be really vlogging tomorrow for the 96-hour readathon, but I'll definitely be vlogging Saturday. But I will try to vlog a little bit. So, but I am going to let you guys go because I'm tired. I want to get this video edited. And yeah, actually, you guys probably won't see this vlog, even though it's Tuesday through Thursday vlog. You probably won't see this up until either Saturday or Monday. So this readathon will be basically almost over. The readathon that I'm starting tomorrow. So, yeah. But yes, I'm so glad. And I don't know when I'm going to be reviewing this, but soon I'll be reviewing it. Maybe I'll review it like Wednesday and put it up that next Friday. Okay, but I'm going to let you guys go, like I keep saying. And I hope you guys are enjoying your reading month. With this book, I finished 9 books this month. And my goal for Goodreads is 100 books. So all I need is 91 more books. And we're only in January, so yay, I still got 11 months and I only need to read 91 books. That sounds like a lot of books, but really when I just read 9 already, yeah. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoy this vlog. I know that my vlogs have been a little bit, reading vlogs have been a little bit longer lately, but yeah, they're going to be that way. I'm trying not to go over between, I'm going to try to stay in between 40 and 50 for reading vlogs, but sometimes it might be over 50. Depends on what I got to say in my vlog, so. But yeah, I will talk to you guys all later. Remember the drill. If you guys love this video, please give me a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed, please think about it. I would love to have you as part of my family. And if you do subscribe, remember to hit that beautiful bell icon, and you'll know when a vlog of mine goes up, a review of mine goes up, a TBR of mine goes up, a unboxing of mine goes up, stuff like that. But I will talk to you guys all later. I hope you guys find one of those books that you really love. Also, let me know some mystery and thrillers that you've liked recently. Bye for now. I love you guys all as a friend, and have a great day.